It's caught in the crossfire. It's caught in. What's up, guys? Lance, the Obscure Movie Guy, coming to you once again with another fun-filled, fact-filled video that you probably won't care about. Trying to change the world one post at a time. And it is Women's History Month. International Women's Day was last week. So I figured, as I did last year, I will do another video in about kick-ass women. Badass actresses, badass characters, as it would be. I've got three films picked out, all relatively the same, I'm not gonna lie to you. But a lot of fun to watch, a lot of kick-assery, and some badass bitches to go along with it. And I found them all on Netflix. I don't think that they're all Netflix originals, but that's where I found them all for a change. So I know most of the stuff I find is on Tubi, but this time I found these on Netflix. And the first one we're going to talk about is a movie that is simply titled Kate.
Kate is a 2021 American action thriller film directed by Cedric Nicholas Troyan and written by Umair Alim. And it stars Mary Elizabeth Winstead and Woody Harrelson. Kate is an assassin expert sniper who eliminates targets chosen by her trusted mentor and handler, Varric, played by Woody Harrelson. After she is left orphaned as a child, Varric raises her as a father figure, giving her extensive training in weapons and combat, and eventually inducting her into his own private team of wet work specialists. Kate is in Osaka, Japan to kill an officer of a powerful Yakuza syndicate, but Kate resists taking the shot because a child has unexpectedly come into view and accompanied him on his travel. She ultimately shoots the target at Varric's insistence. While Kate's assignment is a success, this breach in personal code not to kill in the presence of a child leaves her in emotional turmoil. She tells Varric that she will do one final mission and then wants to retire so that she can start a new life. Before the final mission, however, Kate meets a charismatic stranger, Stephen, at her hotel's bar. The pair share a bottle of wine and the night together in her room. Later, while preparing her sniper's nest the next day, she starts getting symptoms of dizziness that cause her to miss the shot. Kate realizes that Stephen had poisoned her, and after crashing a car, wakes up in a hospital to learn that she has acute radiation poisoning caused by polonium-204 and only has one day to live. She steals injectable stimulant drugs and a gun and sets out to exact revenge on whoever ordered the hit to kill her.
So this movie was a lot of fun, and given the storyline, I think it's safe to say the storyline along with the action, it's pretty much if you took Crank, a Jason Statham film, and then took John Wick and then slammed them together, you would get Kate. And that's not necessarily a bad thing. The fight scenes were amazing, the action sequences were really well done. There was a few CGI moments that it could have gone without, but I really liked the overall setup of the movie. Again, the storyline isn't anything new. Chick who, you know, is orphaned or left behind or whatever the case may be, has a father figure that ultimately turns against her. It's a story that's as old as time, and you'll actually find that in these three movies, that storyline basically goes throughout all three of these films that we're going to talk about. But Kate, overall, really fun film. Mary Elizabeth Winstead did a really good job in the action sequences, did most of her own stunts. The fight sequences were really good. And overall, it's not that enthralling as far as the storyline goes, but it is captivating enough to keep you interested in the long run. Plus, again, because she's on a 24-hour clock, the action never really dies down that much once it gets going. So, really good flick, highly recommend it. I'm all about kick-ass women. I like kick-ass movies. You know, a lot of the stuff I do is action movies, so this one fell right into my wheelhouse, and really well done. The next one I want to talk about, now this was a Netflix original for sure, and damn, it was a fun movie. I really liked it. If anybody's a fan of like Bullet Train with Brad Pitt, you guys would get a kick out of this movie. It's called Gunpowder Milkshake.
Gunpowder Milkshake is a 2021 action thriller directed by Navat Papushido, with a script written by Papushido and Ehud Lavsky. The film stars Karen Gillan as a young hit woman who teams up with her estranged mother, Lena Headey, and former colleagues, played by Carla Gugino, Michelle Yeoh, and Angela Bassett. It also co-stars Paul Giamatti. Film starts out in a flashback set at a diner where 12-year-old girl Sam learns that her mother Scarlett is an assassin and is skipping town after a job gone wrong. Armed men arrive at the diner to kill Scarlett, but she kills them and escapes, leaving an upset Sam behind to be cared for by Nathan, played by Paul Giamatti. Flash forward 15 years, and you find out that Sam works as an assassin for Nathan, the human resources head for the same firm that Scarlett worked for. Nathan gives Sam a new job, killing a man who stole money from the firm and returning the money. Sam goes to a weapons armory disguised as a library to exchange her weapons for new ones. There she meets Anna May, Madeline, and Florence, played by Gugino, Michelle Yeoh, and Angela Bassett, the three former accomplices of Scarlett. They consider killing her for showing up unannounced, but change their minds when they learn of her identity and provide her with clean weapons to do the job.
So this movie is a lot of damn fun, a lot of fun. And again, the storyline, much like Kate, here we have a girl that was young, her mother left her, leaves her with, you know, a father figure that ultimately turns out to be a bad guy in the end. Again, nothing new, it's a storyline as old as time. However, this movie's a riot. I really do like this movie. This is a movie that, a lot like Rocky IV, I could pick up, watch, anytime and not be disinterested at all. It's so much fun. The best highlight of this film for me was when Karen Gillan's character has to fight the three goons that she was fighting in the bowling alley. She has to fight them again at the hospital where her arms are paralyzed. And it's just a riot. She gets scalpels taped to her hands and just starts swinging wildly. And it is a brilliant fight scene that is done super well. And we've seen Karen Gillan kick ass in other movies. Jumanji, Guardians of the Galaxy. So she's pretty cool. And this movie is just, again, it's the storyline's nothing spectacular. It is kind of cool. And again, you do kind of get, I don't want to pick on it, but you do get a little bit of a John Wick type feel, because you have this, you know, in John Wick, it's like all of the hitmen kind of have, like, they live in their own little world, you know, and they visit the Continental. And here it's kind of the same thing. You have the firm, which is like the bad guys hang out where, like, they do all their bidding. And then you've got like this underground, like, pool of women assassins that, you know, they all kind of intermingle with each other. And it just plays out. It plays out really well. It's a very entertaining movie. Again, the storyline isn't anything that's exceptional, but it's a damn good time. It keeps you interested the whole time. CGI, I mean, yeah, it's got a lot of CGI. There's a ridiculous gunfight at the end at the library with a minigun and a Volkswagen bus. And it's just, it's a fun time. It's one of those movies that, like I said, I could pick it up, watch it wherever it is, you know, and just go from there. It's a great flick. I love this one. I highly recommend it. If, like I said, if you like Bullet Train or if you've seen Kate's, I mean, again, John Wick, it's a good time. It's a good freaking time. So the last one I want to talk about, a little bit more serious of a movie, I guess. But again, still kind of falls along the same lines. But this one stars Jessica Chastain, simply titled Ava?
Ava is a 2020 action thriller film directed by Tate Taylor, written by Matthew Newton, and produced by Jessica Chastain's own production company, Freckle Films. The film stars Jessica Chastain, John Malkovich, Common, Gina Davis, Colin Farrell, and Joan Chen. Jessica Chastain plays Ava Faulkner, a recovering drug addict and former soldier who is turned assassin. Ava's handler is a former army superior played by John Malkovich named Duke. Duke sends her to Saudi Arabia to kill a German general. Ava poses as a prostitute, lures the general into a trap, and injects him with a poison to make it appear as though he's going to die of a heart attack. However, she's interrupted by the general's security guards, slices his throat, and a gunfight ensues, leaving all of the general's men dead. Ava then escapes to Barneville, Carteret, where Duke apologizes for the botched operation, insisting that the bad intel that she was given was a simple mistake. He gives her time off to decompress, where she returns to Boston. In the meantime, Duke travels to British Columbia to meet with his superior, a man named Simon. Simon believes Ava is a liability and demonstrates insufficient commitment to their operation. Duke and Simon argue about this, but Duke leaves, and after Duke leaves, Simon reaffirms a hit on Ava, setting out to kill her himself.
So there you have Ava, another kick-ass movie with a kick-ass character played by a kick-ass actress. Now, I will say this for Ava, the storyline does differ a little bit with Duke being, even though Duke is the father figure, he's not the one that actually turns against her. It is Duke's boss that ultimately ends up being the bad guy, and there's nothing Duke can do about it considering that he works for him. So it does differ a little bit in that aspect. Also in Gunpowder Milkshake and Kate, not only is there the father figure to contend with, but there was also small children in both of those instances that helped along the main character throughout the story. So there's that as well. So they do differ a little bit, but not a lot. But again, Jessica Chastain did a really good job. The fight scenes are pretty legit. She did a lot of weapons training, did most of her own stunts, just as the other girls have. And really a solid flick. But again, nothing, you know, as far as that's going to blow you away story-wise. But still a solid movie. And I think it's really interesting to see that, you know, with each of these actresses, we have seen them in other movies that where they do play tough characters, but not necessarily to this degree. I think in all three of these cases, I think if you guys sit down and watch them, we can all agree that these are probably the most physically intense movies that they've done, and probably the grittiest as well. You know, Karen Gillan, you know, again, she did a lot of her own stuff in Jumanji, did a lot of her own stuff in Guardians of the Galaxy. And yes, there are certain action sequences, especially in Guardians of the Galaxy. But there's also a lot of stunt work, a lot of stunt doubles, a lot of CGI. Not so much in Gunpowder Milkshake. Same can be said for Mary Elizabeth Winstead. She doesn't generally play a character that is something you would find in an action movie. And this was a complete 180 for most, you know, for her against most of her other parts that she's played. And Jessica Chastain, we've seen in other movies where she has played a tough girl. But again, not necessarily to the degree of which Ava was. So I think it was a really good take. On a pretty standard storyline for all three movies. I think all three actresses did a really, really good job. And I mean, again, if you like spy movies, hitman movies, John Wick, Bullet Train, Crank, anything like that, that's fast-paced, action-packed, these are definitely three good flicks to check out. So I highly recommend them all. They're all a good time, but if I had to pick one right now, Gunpowder Milkshake for sure. That is a good time. So that's my take on that. That is my take on Women's History Month. You know, wouldn't be where we are without them. I know I wouldn't be where I am in life without my wife. She's the toughest woman I know. And my mom's pretty awesome as well. So shout out to them. Women's History Month, International Women's Day. Keep up the good fight. Guys, like, subscribe, and comment to the YouTube channel. Check me out on Facebook, Tumblr, Reddit. Check out my podcast as well. I would really appreciate a like and a share there if you could do that. And I will see you all in the next video.